If f of x equals the integral of 6t to the second plus 3t minus 2 from 0 to x, then we want to find f prime of x, f prime of 2, and f double prime. So one way of approaching this would be to evaluate this integral and then find the derivative of the result. But we can also determine f prime of x by applying the second fundamental theorem of calculus stated here, where if f is continuous on an open interval containing a constant a, then for every x in the interval, the derivative with respect to x of the integral of f of t from a to x is equal to f of x. So looking at the integral, notice how the lower limit of integration is a constant a, where a is in an interval where f is continuous. The upper limit of integration is x, which is the same variable in which we're finding the derivative with respect to. So to find the derivative of this integral, we simply substitute x for t into f. So going back to our example, if the integral is equal to f, we can say that f prime of x would be equal to the derivative with respect to x of the integral. Notice how this integral does fit the form in our theorem, and therefore to find the derivative of this integral, we substitute x for t, which would just give us 6x to the second plus 3x minus 2. So again, f prime of x is equal to 6x to the second plus 3x minus 2, and therefore f prime of 2, we'll substitute 2 for x, that'll be 6 times 2 squared plus 3 times 2 minus 2. We'd have 4 times 6, that's 24, plus 6, that's 30, minus 2 equals 28. And now to find f double prime, we'll find the derivative of the first derivative, which would be 12x plus 3, applying the power rule of differentiation. Let's also take the time to find f of x by evaluating this integral, and then we'll find the derivative to verify f prime of x is correct. And let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So we'll first find the antiderivative, which would be 6 times t to the third divided by 3 plus 3 times t to the second divided by 2 minus 2t. We evaluate this at x and 0. Let's first simplify this though. This would be 2t to the third plus 3 halves t to the second minus 2t. We'll first substitute x and then we'll substitute 0. So when t is equal to x, we just have 2x to the third plus 3 halves x squared minus 2x. And when t is 0, we just have 0. So now we know that f of x equals 2x to the third plus 3 halves x squared minus 2x. And therefore, we can now find f prime of x, which would just be 2 times 3x to the second plus 3 halves times 2x minus 2 times 1, or just minus 2. So notice f prime of x is equal to 6x to the second plus 3x minus 2, which is the same as what we found when applying the second fundamental theorem of calculus, as we see here. I hope you found this helpful.